वंदे गुरुपद्वंदम भक्तबिंद समन्वितम् श्रीचैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नित्यानंद सहोदितम् श्रीनंदनंदन वंदे राधिका चरणोदयम् गोपीजन समायुक्तं बिंदावनम मनोहरम वांछा कल्पतरुवश कृपा सिंधु व्यवच पतितानं पावने वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयतगिरिं यत्कृपा तमहं वंदे परमानंदमाधव वृंदावि तुलसीदेव वै पिया वै केशव सच भक्ति पदे देवी सत्वत्वी नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीर संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेश गौरीय पत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरुभक्ति युक्त भक्ति प्रमदाक्ष जगोद्वरुण्य धैयम् सदा परिभवग्नमविष्टदूहम् तीर्थास्पदम् शिवभिरुञ्चिनुतम् शरण्यम् भीतात्तिहम् पुनतपालभवाद्विभूतम् वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविन्दम् यत्पादपल्लवनखचन्दमनिच्छटाय विस्फुरजित किमपि गोपवधू स्वदर्श पूर्णानुरागरस सागर सारमूर्ति साराधिकामयि कदा कृपां करोषि श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौरभक्तबिंद श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौरभक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे आजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकावदत संकेतनैकवितरौ कमलायताक्ष विश्वाम्बरौ द्विजवरौ जुगधर्मपालौ वंदे जगत्प्रियकरौ करुणावतारौ हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वंदितो दिव्यरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासि नित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानां गंगातरंगरमणीयजटाकलापं गौरीनिरन्तरविभूषी त्वामभागं नारायणो प्रियमनंगमदापहारम् वाराणसीपुरपति भजवीशनाथम वागीशजुष्वदने लक्ष्मीर्यस्य च वक्षसि यस्यास्ति हृदय संबी त्वं नृसिंहमहं भजे हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। भक्ति स्तई स्थिरतरा भगवान जदीशाद दैवेन न फलत दिव्य किशोर मूर्ति मुक्ति स्वयं मुकृतांजलि सेवति अस्मान धर्मार्थ कामगत यो समयो प्रतीक्षा भक्ति स्तई स्थिरतरा भगवान जदीशाद दैवेन न फलति दिव्य किशोर मूर्ति मुक्ति स्वयं मुकुलितांजलि सेवते अस्मान धर्मार्थ कामगत यो समयो प्रतीक्षा गौरी गोष्ठीपति शिशिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद जगद्गुरु टोल्ड दैट व्हाट यू वांट व्हाट यू डोंट वांट देयर शुड बी ए फाइनल अकाउंट ऑफ दैट फिगर गौरी गोष्ठीपति शिशिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद जगद्गुरु टोल्ड व्हाट यू वांट एंड व्हाट यू डोंट वांट there should be a final account, final settlement of this factor. Otherwise we cannot start actual Hari Bhajan, not possible. All the time bonded soul going to demand this thing, that thing, material mind full of desire, full of anartha, and at the same time, sometimes we want something, after that we want to reject it, why don't want it? So, Srila Prabhupada speaking, there should be a final settlement of this, what you want, what you don't want. Because otherwise we cannot start actual Hari Bhajan. Bonded soul in bonded condition, anyhow, by his personal effort, cannot go out of Maya. By his personal effort, bonded soul can try so much. But by personal effort, a bonded soul can never go out of Maya. Not possible. That's why Srila Saraswati Thakur speaking, the more we can grow our intention, the more we can grow our desire to do Guru Vaishnava Seva, the more we can lose our, you know, attraction for family life, I mean material life. The more we can grow our interest to show, to do Guru Vaishnava Seva, pure Guru Vaishnava Seva, surely. And the more we can grow, you know, our desire to do Guru Vaishnava Seva, the more we can, you know, cut our bondage. Gradually we can go out of Maya. In bonded condition, sometime, maybe some inclination is there, not 100%, but it's because usually at the time of Diksha, most of us cannot show 100% inclination. But without 100% submission, Diksha, this procedure is not complete. So, Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti speaking, sometime some devotee maybe, he is showing 80% submission, maybe 20% gapping there. But anyway, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, he is trying to do some Guru Vaishnava Seva or gradually trying to cut his material bondage. But after some time, that devotee is going to lose his patience. Well, I cannot do bhajan, it's typical, impossible. Because he cannot keep patience. He say it is not possible for me to do, to follow so rules and regulations, so restrictions. Actually, bonded soul like to lead life like a, you know, like a ghost. They never like to put themselves into regulation, rules and regulation, discipline, regulation, all basic thing. They don't like to do. Now, Vishwanath Chakravarti Bhat actually speaking, though by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, they are going to cut their bondage, but they cannot keep their faith up to that point. After some time, they lose their patience. They say, well, it is not possible for us. Because they cannot feel that we are out of Maya, always tension, always different kind of attraction and repulsion coming to put them in trouble. They cannot get the taste of Harinam. they cannot Hari Seva or Guru Vishnu, so they cannot test. Because duplicity is there, they cannot get test. But Vishwanath Chakravarti was speaking, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnav, you are going to cut your bondage, but you don't know. Gradually you are going to cut your bondage, it will take time, but you cannot keep patience up to that point. So you don't know up to which point, up to what point your bondage is already cut. You don't know. You cannot keep patience. Vishwanath Chakravarti was speaking. Suppose you are in chain. Somebody put you in chain. And somebody going to cut the chain gradually. And the chain is almost half cut. Half cut. Chain is almost half cutting done. In that case, same pain you are feeling, you are on the chain, but you are feeling same pain as was before. You cannot believe that 50%, you know, bondage already, you know. This way, actually, they cannot keep patience, they are going to throw Hari Bhajan. But Prabhupada speaking, we should have unending patience. We should have unending patience in Guru Vaishnav Seva. We should have unending patience in Guru Vaishnav Seva. Because why? If you at all interested to do Guru Vaishnav Seva, then 100% you are going to meet with different kind of trouble. Mayadevi is going to put you in trouble. Srila Prabhupada speaking, that actually Guru Vaishnav Seva, if you settle down to do Guru Vaishnav Seva, in course of Guru Vaishnav Seva, countless, you know, problem can come in your life. So Prabhupada speaking, with full patience, with full honor, full respect, full belief, and with full patience, we must do Guru Vaishnav Seva. That is the testing. That's why Prabhupada often used to speak, often used to say, that this material world is a place of painful testing. If we are going to fail in this testing, then never we can start Guru Vaishnava Seva. Guru Vaishnava Seva means Bhagavan Seva. So we cannot do. So with full patience, with full belief, full faith, we must go on doing Guru Vaishnava Seva, Bhagavan Seva. We can go on doing. We should not lose our patience. But main point is that, I was discussing for a long time about how far, how much we are deviated from the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada. And in the whole lifetime of Srila Prabhupada, whole life, the whole leela of Prabhupada, most of the time Prabhupada wanted to cut this, you know, Mayavad Siddhanta, impersonalism, you know, this bhava is topmost enemy of Vipralamba Bhajan. You should remember this point, that if this Mayavad Vichar, this impersonalism, is the topmost enemy of your, you know, Vipralamba Bhajan. And all the time I am speaking by the mercy of Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur, that our Gauriya Bhajan is always Vipralamba Bhajan, all the time crying. Whole day and night you have to cry. You have to cry whole day and night, not for Maya, for Krishna, for Guru Vishnu. All the time you have to cry. Mathur Bhira Brajvasi, you know, you have to think about them and always day and night you have to cry. Because Gauriya Bhajan, you have to cry day and night. This is called Gauriya Bhajan actually. Srila Prabhupada used to speak that most of the people, they are interested about their personal benefit. Some of them want to show their liberal attitude. They are speaking, no, we are not interested about personal benefit, we are interested about public benefit. We are interested about public benefit because those who are going to get popularity, it's a challenge. You can go and test it. Those who are going to enjoy popularity, maybe a spiritual leader, maybe political leader, educational leader, anywhere, social reformer, any. Those who are, you know, going to make some reconciliation, adjustment, they can get, enjoy popularity. So Prabhupada always used to say that those who are going to enjoy popularity, you go through their life, you can find somehow, different way, they always want to invite this mood of adjustment. That they always in the mood of adjustment. They like to bad and good adjustment. It is very easy to say that Asura and Sura. It is very easy to say that Sura and Asura, they should make some adjustment. They should make one common point about adjustment. But practically it is not possible. Practically it is at all not possible, because demigods, their achar-acharan is totally different. And those who are demons, their achar-acharan totally different. Some political leaders say, can speak and get some honor. Okay, we can make some common platform. It's not possible. It is not at all possible. Because oil and water can never mix. Oil and water, can you try to mix oil and water? It is not possible. Oil and water can never mix with each other. It's always have some separate identity. It's a must. It's a must. Nobody can, make a mixture of oil. It's a, oil is over, oil is going to, have some separate identity. Always separate, So all the time, actually, those who are going to prove that we are more liberal, we want to adjust, and like rich man or poor man, and a high Brahmin family and low. Okay, actually we are not going to pass any this kind of, remark, But it is 100% sure the adjustment with oil and water not possible. Demon and those demigods can never get adjusted because they are opposite. Just opposite, they are having some faith in Hari and they don't have faith in Hari. So how they can adjust? Not possible. Someone going to preach this kind of, this kind of mood, and they want to prove they are more liberal, they are very high quality sadhu, and this kind of mood they can preach, but practically it is not possible. Because to make adjustment, you will have to throw some good and take some bad from your opponent group. You will have to. That is called adjustment, which is not at all possible in pure devotional life. If you find some Maharaj, some Acharya going to make this kind of adjustment, be sure he is impersonalist. Not possible. But at heart we can make adjustment. We can think that each and everywhere Krishna is there. Each and everywhere Krishna is there. That we can do. We can see, we can try to see the whole world in relation to Krishna. In relation to Supreme Lord, that we can see. That is called adjustment. We are not going to fight with them, but they are naturally going to fight. It's not possible. This way, somebody, that's why Prabhupada speaking, that with full patience, we will have to go ahead in Hari Bhajan. If we lose our patience, we can get lost in this infinite world. And if we get lost, then everything is, gone, you see. So those who are going to speak, we are not going to join any party because we are neutral. Some group, they are so clever, they want to identify themselves. We are neutral, actually. We are not in any party. We are neutral. But those who are going to prove that we are neutral, they are also going to maintain one party. Because Nirdolio, we are not in a group, actually. Nirdolio, it is also one kind of group. They are very clever. They like to prove we are not in any party, we are neutral. But in this infinity world, nobody can stay neutral. Like I can discuss in Jiva Tattva, Jive Swarupai Krishna Nitya Dasu, many times you hear, and Jive Tatosha Sakti Bhedabed Pokas. But can you prove Tatosha? So what do you mean by Tatosha? Tatosha Bhav. Tatosha Bhav in marginal line between land and water. Tatosha, like in one demarcation line, water and land, there is one line, you can imagine. You can think that this is called a marginal line, this is neutral line, a Tatosha line. But to be frank, actually Tatosha condition is, you know, in Sarup it is there, actually, you can see in Jiva, but Tatosha condition is actually like ideal gas, you know. If you have gone through physics and chemistry, you know, ideal gas. Ideal gas, we take it as granted for calculation. But actually, in fact, ideal gas is not possible. Ideal gas, we can imagine. It is called imaginary. But ideal gas, practically, is not possible. We can find this gas in this temperature, this pressure, this gas can stay in this condition. But this is not actually practically possible. So, Krishna Bhuli Seijiv Anadi Bahirbhu. So, I can go Jeev Tattva. I am not going to discuss Jeev Tattva. So, actually, Tatosha condition is actually, it is one kind of philosophy. Nice. But practically, Jiva can either, you know, they can do Guru Vishnu Seva, Bhagavan Seva, or they can do the service of Maya. In between, we can imagine one line, Tatosha, follow. And anadi infinity period, jivas, some are averse, some are going to serve. I mean, some, this point I can discuss after. So, first of all, Prabhupada speaking, some big leader want to speak that to a personal, we are not going to seek personal or private interest. We are going to seek private interest. I want to prove that we are more liberal, we are big, high, our thoughts is very high, we are very big man, our humanity is very high. But Prabhupada speaking, only and only Prabhupada can speak. Nobody can speak this way. Prabhupada speaking, neither we are interested about private happiness, nor we are interested about public happiness. We are always interested about the total satisfaction, how to satisfy Krishna, Supreme Lord, totally that is our goal. That is our goal. And that is the goal of Rupanuga Bhakta. That is the. We are less interested about private interest, public interest. We are always trying our best to seek the total interest, you know, satisfaction of Supreme Lord. That is our actual bhajan. But bonded soul, it is not possible. At all, if they are coming to do Guru Vaishnava Seva, still, because their heart is more or less contaminated, they cannot expect that without any self-interest they can do Guru Vaishnava Seva. Can you show? It is very easy to proclaim. But practically they cannot show. Practically they cannot prove. All the time they are going to reserve some personal interest for them. That is the main impediments in the way of Krishna Bhajan. That is the main impediments in the way of our Krishna Bhajan. We cannot get respite of this form. But what Mahaprabhu is going to teach us, we are not going to discuss this point, because if we discuss, then somebody can detect my fault, catch me, arrest me. So we are less interested about discussing all these secret points. What we learn from Mahaprabhu, we want to learn from Mahaprabhu. If at all, if you want to learn, we can see Mahaprabhu speaking all the time that na dhanam na janam na sundari kavitam va jagadish kamai mama janmani janmani sara bhavatat bhakti rahituki tvai. This ahituki bhakti, causeless bhakti, There is no cause. If there is any cause for why you are starting bhajan, we are coming to Koriyamat or joining this society, that society, to get some honor, glamour, you know, this way we want to maintain your spiritual life. But this kind of spiritual life is actually useless. You can get some, you can try to get some satisfaction, but actually from heart you cannot get satisfaction. Truly speaking, from heart, because from heart if I get some enjoyment, it's been transcendental bliss. Transcendental bliss, aprakita sukhanubhuti, is only possible when you are going to dedicate your life and soul, everything for Guru Vaishnava, which is next to impossible. Which is just next to impossible and not possible. If you want to get transcendental bliss or prakita sukhanubhuti, then 100% I will have to dedicate all my body and soul, all my belongings, everything unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, which is quite impossible. Even mentally, if you think, mentally if you like to preserve some of your personal right, in that case 100% benefit you cannot get in bhajan track, in the way of bhajan. The sloka I started with is very important sloka. Actually, bhakti, it is by actually Billamangal Thakur. Billamangal Thakur, as from Krishna Karnamrita, is an excellent book. But at present, in this bonded condition, we have no right to discuss this book. But Mahaprabhu bring this book from South India search, and Mahaprabhu wanted to gift these two books. One is Brahma Sangita, another is actually Krishna Karnamrita, two assets. These two are the two assets of Gaudiya Vaishnava society. But you will have to enjoy the full kripa of pure Guru Vaishnava, those are already having Raganuga Bhava inside their heart. Then in that case, you can get the maximum benefit of this sloka. You can realize. To be frank, we have our eternal relationship with Guru Vaishnava. To be frank, actually we have our eternal relationship with Guru Vaishnava. Only we will have to discover this point. Jive Swarup Hoy Guru Nitya Das. I discussed Jive Swarup Hoy Krishna Nitya Das, but more important is that Jive Swarup Hoy Guru Nitya Das. But we cannot feel this point. And we are not established in Guru Tattva. We always make some politics with, it is your Guru, it is our society. Are foolish, we are all one group, Gaudiya group. You can make politics with this point, but you cannot come into this platform because your heart is contaminated with Mayavad Vichar. This is our Guru, this is your Guru, this is our society, this is your... This kind of fighting going on. Though anybody going to this kind of fighting, be sure, is not at all established in Guru Tattva. Ravan also can express grit, you know. Ravan can recite so many things. Ravan can memorize Vedanta, Mayavad Vedanta, full Vedanta. Ravan can recite. So what? Ravan can write, you know, stotra very quickly. He is a learned man, big learned. When Ravan going to do arati of Shankar Bhagavan, then daily Ravan used to make new stotra, instant. Not that after writing, after memorizing, not that. So we are so foolish, we are deviated from the track of Prabhupada. So we cannot understand what is bhakti, what is not bhakti. We are attracted by apparent glamour. Apparent glamour. This prakriti in nature going to open one big exhibition for us. Varieties of exhibition. Items are varieties of exhibition. Countless items. Maybe you are attracted by something. I am attracted by something. She is attracted by something. So it is called actually one big, you know, exhibition opened by Mayabadi, Mayadevi to catch you. It is one kind of trap in which if we put our leg into that trap, then we can go into the lobby of Mayadevi. We can go on enjoying her. Actually, we cannot enjoy Maya. Prabhupada wanted to explain this point countless times. But we are so idiot, we don't like to understand this point. Prabhupada wanted to explain that it is not possible to enjoy Maya. But we are bonded soul, we are always interested to enjoy Maya. You don't understand what I mean to say. You know what is the meaning of Diksha? What is the meaning of Diksha? What is the actual procedure of Diksha? When and how and from whom we can get Diksha? You don't understand because you are contaminated with Mayavad Vichara. You cannot understand, you are not interested to accept the Vichara Prabhupada. I know it very well. I know it very well. That's why yesterday I was writing one small note about Is this preaching or cheating? What? Actually, Diksha means for infinite period, we bonded soul having a constant flow of enjoying mood. Constant flow, non-stop constant flow of enjoying mood. This enjoying mood mean material enjoyment. Material enjoyment mean I am interested to enjoy something which is material. Like one man want to enjoy woman. One woman like to enjoy a man. This is called nature. It is false identity. It is false identity that you are a woman. It is false identity that you are a man. But they are attracted with each other. How to cut this bondage? Eh? Because the topmost bondage. Eh? There is a topmost bondage. Nobody can, compare with this bondage. It is the topmost bondage. Bandhaschanna pasangata. Yashit sangadi yatha punso tatha tatsangi sangata. Yashit means in Gaudiya society, I already explained big way. Yashit doesn't mean only the body of woman or only the body of man. Yashit means whatever thing you are thinking as your object of enjoyment. That is called Yashit. Suppose Lab Puja Patishtha. So this become a Yashit Sangha for you. You want to get huge amount of money, you want to get huge amount of Pratishtha, this is also Yashit actually. Na tathasya bhavet bandho, na tathasya bhavet bandho, bandhaschanna prasangataha, yashit sangyad yatha pungsa tatha tatsangi sangataha. Na tathasya bhavet bandho, this kind of tight bondage is impossible. This kind of tight bondage is quite impossible. It's possible, not possible. Na tatha asya bhavet bandho, bandhascha anna prasangata, anna prasangata. From other factor, you cannot get this kind of bond. What you can get from Yashit Sangha. Na tatha asya bhavet bandho, bandhascha anna prasangata, Yashit Sangha di yatha pungso tatha tatsangi sangata. Yashit Sangha and tatsangi, anybody going to get their association, if knowingly or unknowingly going to get their association, then also it is one kind of, it is contaminated disease. It is bondage. Yashit Sangha, directly or indirectly, those who are going to take the association of Yashit Sangha, those who are going to get the association of Yashit Sangha, if you are going to get their association, it is also bondage. So how to, if I explain in a big way, then you can go mad. You can say, Maharaj, it is next to impossible to do Hari Bhajan. There is a big network of Mayadevi. There is a big network of Mayadevi to put you in trouble. How analytically you will have to think by the mercy of Guru Vaishnav, by the power of your Guru Vaishnav Seva. That's, you don't understand what is Guru Seva, Vaishnav Seva. That is the main point. Tat vidhi punipateno paribeshana sevaya. This slok, if you can feel from heart, then you can start Guru Seva. Then you cannot complain that I have taken shelter of Gurudev, but I am not getting power. Why? What can be the reason? You think yourself. What can be the reason? Foolish. You think why? Tat vidhi punipateno paribeshana sevaya. Upadikshanti to te gyanam gyanina sattva darshinaha. This is the procedure. This is the procedure through which you can grow knowledge, dibbogyan. And dibbogyan, how you can get? Dibbogyan means deep dhatu, means very bright knowledge. Bright, very bright. Like Urjita Bhakti Vena, Ujjeshwari Radharani, Urjabhato. Urja means very bright, clean, without any spot, without any marking, nothing, very clean and transparent. Very clean. But it's not possible. Actually, I am not going to explain, my point is totally different today. But still, under the guidance of Prabhupada, I like to discover that how much, how far, I am deviated from the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada. Prabhupada always and every time wanted to speak that Diksha means you will have to grow Dibbogyan. You will have to grow Dibbogyan. I know, bonded soul, they have continuous flow of one mood of enjoyment there. Continuously. Bonded soul, they are continuously non-stop flow of enjoying mood. Going on. So what is the utility of Diksha if you are not going to cut this thing? What is the utility of Diksha? The same thing, when I was in bonded condition, when I have taken Diksha, I think I am out of bondage, but same condition prevailing. Because I don't understand what is the utility of Diksha. And so many devotees, they are also so-called devotees fighting. They don't understand. You should have direct link with Guru Vaishnava. You should have somebody complaining, Maharaj, we are hearing Harikatha from you over internet, not directly. So this is actually how it is, we can get same result. I say foolish. Foolish you are. Actually, if you have relationship with me through your bani, this directly, you know, and you meet me, sometime you send letter, you meet me, direct conversation, everything possible. When Guru Vaishnav going away from this world, this kind of scope you cannot get, usually you are not going to get. Sometime it is a rare case. Sometime Guru Vaishnav gone, and sometime come in dream, going to help me, because Guru Vaishnav not going to die. But as for Diksha, you should have direct relationship with Guru Vaishnava. You should have direct relationship with Guru Vaishnava. This is a must. Without which, how you can expect that you are taking, like Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, he is already getting sannyas mantra from Srila Prabhupada. But Gurupada Padma never wanted to break the system. He came, Prabhupada came, It was almost in dream, almost a dream, but not dream. But Gurupada Padma getting mantra from him, got mantra. But still Gurupada Padma thinking that if I am going to proclaim that I already have received mantra, sannyas mantra from Prabhupada, then this kind of system can, everybody can follow this system. Mahayana jenu gato sabandha so. If those big personalities, the important personalities going to follow this system, all the common people, they also jat jat acharati sestas tatta devetaro janah sajat pramanam kurutes lokohas tadanu vartate. That's why Guru Vaishnava is so careful, so careful, they are going to think about past, present and future, so that disturbance cannot take place. But at present you see, countless guru coming out of their cave. So long they are staying inside the cave, we find countless guru coming. Coming out of the cave. They all want to act as guru. This is the system at present. So anyway, it is there, bichar, what to do, what not to do. I don't like to fight with them, but how far we are deviated from the track of Prabhupada, that is our, main bichar. So actually, Prabhupada speaking, diksha min, you will have to take shelter unto lotus feet of Guru Padma, and surely after realizing that this world material was unstable. Surely, after realizing that this material world is unstable, if you think this material is good, very nice, then why you are giving diksha? Diksha means you will have to proceed towards Supreme Lord. You will have to proceed toward that absolute goal. And that absolute goal, absolute God, Supreme Lord is absolute truth. But if I am going to worship that absolute truth and I am not going to take shelter of that absolute truth, I am going to take advantage of, all false philosophy, this, that. In that, what kind of Hari Bhajan I can do? Satyam cha satyam nihitam cha satye. Bhagavan is Sarupi Satya. Bhagavan, Supreme Lord and Guru Vaishnava, they are Sarupi Satya. Because Guru Vaishnava, already established into the lotus feet of Nityananda. Nitai charan satya taharo sevak nitya. Nitai charan sada karo ash. You forget this kirtan. Nitai charan satya taharo sevak nitya. Nitai pado sada karo ash. You never try to think this point. You always think, this Vaishnava is not Brahman. This Vaishnava is not educated so much. This Vaishnava is, no affluence, is useless. This is our calculation. This is our calculation about Guru Vaishnava. That's why many times Prabhupada used to speak that Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan can reserve the right of not being exposed to a sense organ. But what to do? We have nothing, we have no other facility than our sense organ. Only we have our property that were bonded, sense organ and mind. That is our property. That is our power. With the help of these sense organs and mind, and maybe material money power, material, manpower, educational power, this is our duty. We always try to put some calculation, estimation. Always, calculation we have. Oh, maybe Guru Vaishnava is this, maybe Bhagavan is this. But what is Bhagavan? Who is Guru Vaishnava? It's inconceivable. Prabhupada speaking, if somebody going to have some material idea about Guru, Vaishnava, Bhagavan, Dham, Nam, etc., about Aprakita Nam, Aprakita Dham, Aprakita Guru, Vaishnava, Aprakita Bhagavat, Tatha, Aprakita, Vigraha, if they have no belief in it, then maybe they are coming in Gauriya Bhajan. Prabhupada speaking, day and day by day, they can grow false, vairagya. Day and day by day, they can grow false vairagya. Day by day, they can go deep into mayavad bichar. Externally, they can have sannyas vrata, acharya vrata. They can have full decoration of society. Full designation is very good, everything. But ultimately, all null and void. Null and void. Or null and void, nothing else, no concrete result. That is why Prabhupada used to speak all the time that diksha means you will have to take diksha from such a exalted personality, such a big, devotee whose realization power is up to that point. Because diksha means Gurudev going to inculcate, transfer, going to inculcate his own bhava inside your heart. So Prabhupada explaining, Guru Bhargava explaining that Diksha means for so long time, for infinity period, though you have a constant flow of enjoying mood inside your heart. But if you are fair and above board, there is no duplicity, if you approach Guru Vaishnava, and what is the procedure of Diksha, that Sanatana Goswami only, Mahaprabhu already saw. But we are listening, we want to follow some material procedure. Oh, your Diksha is done. Ah, you go. Diksha is done. But they are not going to follow the procedure shown by Srila Prabhupada. Even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking in Gayadham in front of Ishwar Paripad, what speaking? We have no time to discuss all this point. Very sad. We have no time to discuss all this point. We are busy with our material activities. We have no time. Siddhanta boliya chitte na karo alos, ya hoite Krishna lage sudhiro manos. But who can speak to whom? We are all king in our kingdom. Amra sabai raja amaderi raja rajote in Bengali. In Bengali, there is a nice proverb. We are all king in our kingdom. Who can rule whom? Who can give instruction to whom? Amra sabai raja amaderi raja rajote. We are all king in our own Helen. We are all king. So who is going to follow whom? So the system is total breakdown. Breakdown. So actually, Siddhanta Bolya Chitta Nakari Alas, Ihamiti Krishna Lage Sudhira Manus. If you are not going to understand this Siddhanta or Vichar, then never you can get bhakti. Siddhanta Bolya, because without faith in Krishna and Guru, how we can get bhakti? So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also in Gayadham speaking in front of Ishwar Puripat, ei ami deho tomai korinu samarpan. Now I am going to offer my body and soul unto your lotus feet. Ei ami deho tomai korinu samarpan. Follow. Ei ami deho tomai korinu samarpan. This is my soul and body. I am going to offer unto your lotus feet. Now, you will have to deliver me from this material ocean, Maya, material ocean of Maya. So you see, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, everything teaching us, but we are going to make different kind of rules and regulation. Each and everybody. They are going to make some separate rules and regulations. They are going to make some separate constitution. They are going to follow that. Oh, it is their rules. We cannot follow this. Everybody is speaking this. They are making some different rules and regulation criteria. They are going to follow some, you know, instruction. They are going to follow this. But anyway, they cannot prove that they are going to follow Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. And they cannot prove. That's because they are totally deviated from the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada. And Sanatana Goswami also putting this question, even in Bhagavatam, Parikshit Mahara, many times before I discussed this point, I have no time to discuss this basic point again and again. Sanatana Goswami speaking in front of Mahaprabhu, Ke ami kene more jare tapatroy, iha nahi jani koisha mori hithoy. I don't know the reason for why these three modes of nature are always going to put me in trouble. Please show me the reason. Take me out of Maya. Sanatana Goswami speaking. Sanatana Goswami speaking this way, na? So you see the quality, basic quality of a man, a candidate who can take Diksha. But what kind of calculation you are doing? You are one so always want to increase the number of asura. You wanted to increase the number of asura in your society. Asura. This you can do. You are speaking this, you know, 50,000 or 1 lakh, 2 lakh people, they are initiated in our society. So I can show that nobody initiated it. As per the Siddhanta Prabhupada. Sanatana Goswami is speaking this way. Sanatana Goswami is speaking, Ke ami kene more? Who am I? What is my actual identity? Ke ami kene more? Jare tapatra hai. By three modes of nature always going to put me in trouble. I don't know how to go out of this problem. Please show me the way out. This is the quality of a man who is really interested to take Diksha. Diksha doesn't mean I can take Diksha unto a lotus feet of influential leader as having big affluences and, you know, society big this, that. Okay, I can also enjoy. So I can take the uniform of a sannyasi, a brahmachari. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, that's why 150 years back, started crying. His crying is going on still today. You cannot see. You are blind. Bhaktivinoda Thakur still today crying. 150 years back, Bhaktivinoda Thakur started crying. We are not going to protect the glory of Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu's prema dharma. We are not going, we are going to lose. Yeah, we cannot protect the glories of this, you know, pure Bimal, pure Prema Dharma, shown by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. If this kind of contamination going on, day by day, we can increase the number of animals, we can increase the number of demons, increase the number of rakshas in our society. But I am sure that you cannot make one devotee. If you can make one devotee, if you can make one devotee, genuine devotee, that genuine devotee can, you know, rescue the whole world. Like Srila Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj wanted to. So Nitya Leela there. They are Nitya, Nitya Sambandha. We have our eternal relationship with Guru Vishnu. You cannot feel it. We have to feel it. That we have our eternal relationship with Guru Vishnu, but we cannot feel it. That is the main problem. So Sanatana Goswami is saying, Sanatana Goswami want to speak that way, and you know, also, you know, Parikshit Maharaj speaking that way, Mahaprabhu speaking that way, but we are not going to follow the way shown by Srila Prabhupada. We are deviated. We are deviated. Now you can fight with me that those who already was initiated by Prabhupada, they also gone out of order. Okay, that doesn't mean that Prabhupada was not powerful. Many of them, because I already told at the time of Diksha, Prabhupada wanted to grow Dibya Gyan inside them, 100%. Prabhupada is so powerful. Prabhupada was so powerful. But by chance, if they make some aparat, and that the amount of aparat going up and up, then increasing aparat going to decrease there by, you know, they are going to increase their aparat, but due to aparat, they are going to lose their consciousness. Due to aparat, they are going to lose their consciousness, and gradually they are going to lose consciousness. This way they are debating. Usually, Prabhupada used to test them before coming. Prabhupada used to test them. Prabhupada had that kind of power to test them, what reason for why they have come. But maybe after that grow aparat and increasing amount of aparat going to make them, you know, fall down. They are going to lose their consciousness this way. So, Diksha actually Prabhupada wanted to prove that you will have to grow your consciousness and Purna Chetan Vastu, Gurupad Padma Purna Chetan Vastu, Purna Tamo Chetan Vastu is Krishna. And Guru Vaishnava always in touch with Purna Vastu, say they are also Purna. Follow what I mean to what is the Siddhanta. If you are always in touch with Purna Vastu, then you are also Purna. Why Guru Vaishnava always Purna? Why Guru Vaishnava always feeling satisfaction? No doubt, because they are in touch with Purna Vastu. In Purna, if you are in touch with Purna Vastu, you also can get satisfaction inside heart. No dissatisfaction. Now I go back to the point. So you see, not that anybody can come and even without asking, those who are big acharya, they are going to give diksha without asking. Please save me from Maya. They are not speaking. They say, okay, you come. We can give diksha. I can give diksha to you, Mayavad. I can give diksha to you, but you cannot deliver yourself. How you can deliver him? If you are established in full consciousness, then you should have a right to give consciousness, distribute consciousness among devotees who are coming to you. You should have. So this way actually, Diksha, Prabhupada wanted to speak this way. Those who are coming in Gauriya Math, those who are coming in Gauriya Math with a separate desire, you know, to fulfill their secret game, to fulfill their separate game, they like to play game. Those who are coming to Gauriya Math with a desire to fulfill their secret game, they are actually Gauriya Math cannot have, doesn't have any connection with them. Those who are coming in Gauriya Math to misuse the divine knowledge available here, Gauriya Math cannot have and doesn't have any relationship, connection with them. Gauriya Math cannot have. This is the Siddhanta, but we are going to show just opposite Siddhanta Vichar. Just some time before I was speaking that Mayadevi is going to open a big exhibition. We are going to speak Mayadevi opened a big exhibition in this material world. Big exhibition all the time. We are attracted by the exhibition. There are different kind of items, countless items. This material body full of blast and blood and flesh is attracted by another, you know, woman full of, you know, blood and flesh. One sack is attracted by another sack. Because Atma is beyond your, you know, imagination. That's why Nayam Atma Pravachanena Lobhyo Na Medhaya Na Bhuna Sutena Jam Eva Isa Vinute Tena Lobhyo is sloka coming. So what we are going to learn from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? When Mahaprabhu teaching us, but we are not going to learn that thing. Mahaprabhu, na dharam, na janam, na sundari kavithamba jagadish kamaye mama janmani janameswara mama janmani janameswara bhavata dhakti haitu gitri. Mahaprabhu praying unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord that way. But the procedure of our bhajan is totally opposite. Without any demand, without any anartha, without any, you know, interest, we are not ready to do the seva of Guru Vaishnava. That's why we cannot come out successful. Why we cannot come out successful? This is the only reason. This is the only reason. When we are going to get bhakti, then bhakti is the sarup shakti. Then we can get satisfaction. Because bhakti is amrita sarupa. Bhakti is amrita sarupa. Bhakti is amrita sarupa. So if we can get bhakti, then there is no question of any fighting. We are not gaining bhakti. That's why politics going on. That's why in Upanishad it is written, amrita sarupa cha. Bhakti amrita sarupini and om jam labdhya Pumano Siddha Bhavati, Amriti Bhavati, Tripta Bhavati. It is written in Narad Bhakti Sutra. Bhakti Revainam Nayati, Bhakti Revainam Darshayati, Bhakti Basha Purushaha, Bhakti Deva Bhuyasi. Why? This is all given Matar Shruti. It is written. Bhakti can only can take us unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Bhakti Revainam. Evo, bhakti only an affirmative. Bhakti revainam nayati, bhakti revainam darshayati, bhakti basha purushaha, bhakti reva huyasi. But we are less interested about the bhajan procedures shown by Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Each and everybody, all society, want to make one separate branch. In Bengali, we said bhinno goat. Srila Bhamanga Goswami also used to say bhinno goat. They already make to want to make a separate goshala in which they can bring so much cow, bhinno goat. But then they are not going to follow any rules and regulation shown by Prabhupada. They want to make some new rules and regulation system. Hare Maharaj, in this material world this is applicable. Well, how you are going to apply in your society, if at all it is spiritual society? If at all you want to speak in spiritual, how you are applying? In material world, we know that any kind of amendment, rectifies amendment can be done. In constitutional change, these are rules and regulations. But in spiritual world, without tremendous love, we cannot change even one single point. When there is tremendous love, then Krishna not going to mind anything. Aham bhakta paradhina hi asatantri vadi jo, that Krishna can speak that time. I am controlled by devotee. That is the extreme point. But bhakti, if we are going to get bhakti, then totally we can get satisfaction. But we are not going to get satisfaction. That's mean there is some duplicity. So there is separate rules and regulations, separate, you know, constitution they are making. This is for our society. We are not going to follow the rules and regulations set by Prabhupada. Even those wanted to utilize this diksha, they got diksha from Prabhupada, but after that wanted to utilize this, you know, facility that we are initiated by Prabhupada. All of them, they got heavy punishment by Mayadevi. Mayadevi, if we are going to, you know, we were going to express some doubt about Guru, Vaishnava, Bhagavan, the eternal future, then Mayadevi is surely going to kick us. Mayadevi is surely going to kick us and throw us into the ocean of Maya again. By chance, in course of our traveling for infinity period, Brahmanda Bhamita Guna Bhakka Vanjeev, Guru Vishnu Prasade Pai Bhakti Lata Bich. I have no conception about Dushanga, what is bad association, what is good association, how to avoid bad association. We are all mixed. And nobody want to maintain this pure, you know, system. Because if there is no contamination, then how I can protect myself? There should be contamination. It is good. On the contrary, they can put that they have conservative attitude. They are not sadhu actually. That's why Prabhupada is not sadhu. You are sadhu. Prabhupada is not sadhu. Because Prabhupada wanted to show the exact way through which you can get exact result. That's why Prabhupada is not sadhu. Those who are going to cheat us, they are sadhu. Is preaching or cheating? What is this? Is preaching or cheating? We will have to understand this one. We are so foolish, we don't understand this one. So how far, how much we are deviated from the track of Prabhupada, that should be calculated. So, actually Mayadevi is going to open a big exhibition and we all are attracted by this exhibition. There are so many countless items are there and all regarding if we like to do bhajan, we own the thing, we have no property, only our material sense organ and mind. Only our material sense organ and mind is the only support. But if you going to get this kind of support, never you can come out successful. Never. Because in Gita, Bhagavan already told, all your mind is material, your brain is material, your buddhi is material, eh? All material. Khiti, apo, tej, marud, bom, all, everything material. All, everything material. So with the help of this material thing, we'll have to understand what is there in this transcendental world. That is why we cannot come out successful. Aprakita vastu kabu prakita gochar noy. We forget this point, aprakita vastu kabu prakita gochar noy. Aprakita vastu, transcendental objectives. Aprakita jaga, aprakita vastu, by material help, we cannot understand. Aprakita vastu kabu prakita gochar noy. We cannot understand. But what to do? We are always ready to apply our brain, our, you know, rationality, all this. We are going to. Bhumi rapo analo khang buddhi ma, eh? Bhumi rapo analo, eh? Bhumi rapo analo mano khang buddhari, khang mano buddhi revacha. Ahankari ityamme prakriti rastoda. All eight different kind of no categories of same prakriti. Bhumi rapo analo mano. Apo. Bhumi rapo analo khang mano buddhi revacha. All, you know, material things. With the help of thing, we like to enter into the court of Mayadev. Into the court of prakriti jagat. In the area. So we are always failure. This is the point. So, what is the duty of a Sadguru? Try to understand. Try to understand this is, so, this is the actual procedure shown by Prabhupada. For so long, for infinity period, I am going to get continuous, non-stop flow of enjoying mood. By the procedure of Diksha, today, by the mercy of Gurudev, if I am going to break this conception, and if I am going to make a new conception, new interest, new, you know, enjoyment to do Guru Vaishnava Seva, then somebody can fight, what use, so many shastra, so many lecture, harikatha is there, what use? Eh? If it is beyond our reach, but actually Siddhanta is there. If you are fighting, you can fight. But actually Siddhanta is there. That if you are going to grow a little bit, slightly you are going to change your mood. Day by day you are growing your interest to hear the Harikatha from a pure Vaishnava. Day by day you are growing your interest to, you know, do some seva, mood. Seva, actual seva you cannot start without Diksha. Without Diksha, actual seva is not started as yet, but still you can grow some interest. In that case, those Shastra can help you. In that case, though, that's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, if so long as they are totally in absorbing mood, they are less interested about, forcefully you cannot change their mind. Any amount of your preaching, any amount of your argument cannot stand. Cannot stand. If you are not going to get established in acharan, at the same time, if they are not at all interested to hear you, totally absorbed in Maya, in that case, no procedure. Any amount of preaching cannot give result. If somehow their mood is changing a little bit, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, they have not done no aparad, only papa, then gradually they are interested to hear judgment because they cannot understand. In preliminary stage, they cannot understand what kind of Siddhanta they cannot understand. If they go on hearing, gradually, and they can grow they are interested to know all tatvagyan, and finally if they are going to take decision to take shelter unto the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava, then their journey towards that aprakita goal can start. So by your idealism, by your seva mood, if somebody is, you know, going to change their mood, then it is good symptom. It's very good. In that case, they can hear on Harikatha Shastra. To be frank, if you are very intelligent, you like to go through Bhagavad Gita, everything, but still you cannot get realization without Diksha. Maybe you have your money, but you are very intelligent, you want to know so many things, you can buy books, but it is a system that without taking shelter unto the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava, you cannot have direct realization power. Maybe you are very intelligent, but until and unless you are actually initiated by pure Guru Vaishnava, then you cannot get realization power. So you can show so many things, you know, but without the kippa of pure Guru Vaishnava, you cannot realize Shastra. What is written in Shastra, you cannot realize it. So before going through Bhagavatam, this, that, you will have to get initiation for pure Chaitanya Bhagavat, Chaitanya Chaitanya. You can go, but you cannot get realization. Realization is only possible by the mercy of pure Guru Vaishnava. Otherwise, you cannot get. So before taking admission in, you know, in this aprakita jagat, I mean, you know, aprakita jagat, you like to learn so many siddhanta, vichar, everything, but without taking initiation unto the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava, you cannot. You can read, but you cannot get realization power without the kippa of Guru Vaishnava. So, without the kippa of Guru Vaishnava, we cannot get realization power. Is impossible. So, Mayadevi is going to open some big exhibition. We can get attracted according to our previous sanskar. According to our previous sanskar, we can get attracted. But what to do? We can get attracted according to previous sanskar, and we can jump into fire. As somebody already in frying pan, and from frying pan, they are going to jump into fire. Same thing. This is the difference. So, to get result, actually, Wallace Prabhupada wanted to speak that each and every time, every moment, you will have to realize this material world is unstable. Don't try to get any interest out of Guru Vaishnava Seva. You are showing that you are doing Guru Vaishnava Seva, but out of that Guru Vaishnava Seva, you are going to reserve your personal right. Infinity pure, you cannot get any result in bhajan. That is the main chronic disease in your life. There is a chronic disease in our life that we... This is a chronic disease. Aprakita vastu kabhu prakita gochan noy. That's why Rupa Goswami already told, no aprakita tami ha bhakta jana sapaset. Many times. So, if somebody going to develop distrust in Guru Vaishnava, Bhagavan and Vigraha, then they can grow some dry vairagya. They can go some dry vairagya, they are going to get deviated from the track of Prabhupada. Whereas slightest deviation from the track of Guru Padma, Prabhupada can throw us away from the mainstream, Bhaktivinoda Dara. We can get deviated. So, Bhaktivinoda Dara speaking, any amount of preaching cannot give any result. If you can change their mind somehow, if they are little at all interested to know something, if you are less interested, you can go on speaking with me. Big problem. So, if I am not established in tattva, If I am not established in seva, then I cannot go for preaching, not possible. But what I can preach? Preaching means you will have to share your bhakti, your bhav, with those bonded souls. So, a preaching, so in whole life, Prabhupada always wanted to fight with Mayavad impersonalism. Because Prabhupada used to speak, this Mayavad impersonalism is the topmost enemy in the way of your Vipralamba Bhajan. Just opposite pole. Just opposite pole. So, just opposite pole. So, those who are going to make a mixed sampradaya, all different people, mixed sampradaya. They never want to eliminate one by one. This is pure devotional line, this is no contamination. They don't like to do it. Because otherwise, how they can run? This is the procedure actually. So, actually, each and everybody, we are attracted by the magic spell of Maya. This is the magic spell of Maya. So, Narottama Thakur also crying, Maya re kuriya jai charano na jai, Sadhguru kipa bina na dekhi vai. That's why Prabhupada always used to advise that every fraction of second, you will have to realize this material world is unstable. If you can realize this point, then you can never feel any attraction in this material world. All repulsion. This life is unstable, all those things are unstable all around you. You have to feel this point first. All the time you have to feel this point. Otherwise, Prabhupada speaking, those who are having, you know, great attraction for money, position, appliances, they want to collect so huge amount of money, Prabhupada speaking, it is not our duty, as a devotee, it is not our duty to collect huge amount of money. It is not our duty. Because if we gather huge amount of money, then we can insult Guru Vaishnava. We can think they are useless. But because due to, you know, money power, we can grow false ego. Educational power, money power, manpower can grow. You know, then we can, you know. So, Prabhupada speaking, that those who are going to collect huge amount of money and going to utilize it for their personal interest, Lakh Puja Patishtha, I want to beg one, you know, blessing from Supreme Lord, so that rest of my life, you know, up to my last moment, I need not see their face. I don't like to see their face. They are pashando. They are pashando, infinity pure, they cannot get bhakti. Prabhupada in his Patravali writing. So, Rupanuga devotees, they are never having this kind of enjoying mood. They are never having. A Rupanuga devotee never going to find faults with others, with pure devotees. They never like to find any fault with pure devotees. They never try to find any fault with pure devotees. Why we are trying to get Lakh Puja Patishtha? Because we are deviated from the track of Prabhupada. That's why Prabhupada, Vaishnavi Patishtha, Tate Karanishtha, Tahana Kurile, Vivar Aura. And Prabhupada speaking, Ravan is the embodiment of Pratishtha. Ravan is the embodiment of Pratishtha. Ravan is the embodiment of Patishtha, false Patishtha. In material world, in this 14 world, not in this material world, everybody busy with material Patishtha. Nobody can go out of that. So, Prabhupada writing, Patishtha Satoru, Jaro Maya Maru, Napelo Ravan, Jujhiya Raghav, Vaishnavi Patishtha, Tatekara Nishtha, Tahana, Bajile, Ravive Rora. Ravan wanted to put challenge in front of Raghunath. Ravan wanted to get all Pratishtha. Ravan wanted to get all Pratishtha. Even it is the desire of impersonalist, Mayavadi, they going to they want to destroy this Bhagavad Tattva or Shakti Tattva. Either they are going to destroy Shakti Tattva or going to destroy Bhagavad Tattva. So Ravan what to do? Ravan actually want to get Pratishtha. Ravan always watching the whole world is my, whole world is the objective of my enjoyment, all items of my enjoyment. Anywhere Ravan looking, Ravan watching, oh, I can enjoy this way, I enjoy that way. So it is a conception of Ravan, the ultimately, that much audacity Ravan going to express, he want to take, he want to enjoy the Shakti Sita of Ram, Supreme Lord. This is the, actually, this is the, you know, procedure of a Mayavadi, impersonalist. Ultimately, they want to enjoy the Shakti, 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 Mator, Abhed. Shakti and Shaktiman, non-different from each other. But they think, we can destroy Shakti, we can take Shakti, we can enjoy Shakti. This is the mood. So ultimately, Ravan wanted to enjoy Sita, which is impossible, quite impossible. So you see, this is the procedure, and we are hearing so much Harikatha, but we are not going to stop Asasanga. I am sure. I am sitting in Vyasasana, I am sure. Otherwise, we are going to get result, 100%. Because knowingly, unknowingly, we are going to do Asasanga. Prabhupada always wanted to speak that Vaishnavi Pratishtha, you must honor Vaishnavi Pratishtha. If you are not going to show honor to Vaishnavi Pratishtha, then you can fall down. Vaishnavi Pratishtha means you can see the whole world with no enjoying mood. You can see any amount of Pratishtha coming, anything, you are not going to accept those enjoying mood. All you are going to pass on to the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan. This you can do. This is called, you know, this is called. Now what kind of preaching going on? I was discussing maybe 8 months ago, 1 year ago, I was discussing what kind of preaching. I am already in Maya. I am going for preaching. I am already in Maya. So I am in Maya. I am going to, how I can saving from my, say the one in one nice story I learned from Guru Varga. So one parrot was there, one parrot, and that parrot was taught that anybody coming, that parrot is habituated to speak. Hey, the hunter can come, make a nice network and catch you and go away. Be careful about that. Hey, sikari aayego. जाल बिछाएगो, गो पकार के ले जाएगो, सावधानी से रहना, is learning. Parrot can memorize everything all the time. Anything, anybody coming is, you know, pet parrot, or is open there. And there, and the man household has, you know, gone outside, and the hunter coming, it is in a, almost near, you know, forest, it is, you know, forest. So hunter coming, I'm making a nice network and giving nice, you know, lucrative offer so that the parrot can jump. And the net is ready and the parrot speaking all the time. Hey, be careful, always be careful. The hunter can come and, you know, can make a nice network and catch you and go away. Be careful about that. But is not it, that parrot never understand the actual meaning, only memorize. Then when the network is there, lucrative offer was there, that parrot is going to jump into the net and already, that hunter catch and go. So Guru Varga speaking and laughing, this kind of preaching, our preaching. Already I am in Maya, I am going to cut your mind, how possible? Only memorize some sastra. Then memorize some sastra. Big sastra quotation. Memorizing and going to speak. This cannot give any results. you know. And one point we should realize from heart, never we can enjoy Maya. Maya re koiya joy charano na jai, Prabhupada speaking, to cut Maya from heart we will have to serve pure Guru Vishnu. Then we can automatically cut. Not only that, when you are, but also when you are serving Guru Vishnu, serving Guru Vishnu means if you are doing some seva for them, at the same time we should realize the Bani Sharo. We should hear. Anybody going to hear the Bani of Prabhupada, I mean, hear, you know, try to do seva of Prabhupada without the help of Bani Sharo, then it is useless. Great problem can be there. So actually, Atma Vastu has no relationship with Maya. This simple point, basic point we don't understand, that the Chidatma has not at all any relationship with Maya. But we are in Maya. How possible? Prakriti Purushena cha. Purush and Prakriti. Purush and Prakriti, I mean bonded souls, they are also Purush having some enjoyment, that's why Purush. And Param Purush is Supreme Lord. Prakriti Purushena cha. With Prakriti and Purush, if Prakriti is alone, then there we cannot get anything, Srishti. Purush and Prakriti, or bonded souls, they are coming with enjoying mood. They are, by Mayadevi, they are given different body and mood. They are growing according to their previous sanskar. Now they are with full enjoying mood. They can jump into Maya, enjoying mood. But they don't understand. We can pass lecture, but it is quite impossible to realize that foolish, you cannot enjoy Maya. You cannot enjoy Maya, it is not possible for you to enjoy Maya. Follow. We cannot enjoy Maya. We always try to enjoy Maya in naked form. That's why Kali wanted to show naked form and laughing. You all Jivatma like to enjoy me, yeah, up to the extreme point, even Ravan. Even more than Ravan. At present, new Ravan coming, their quality is more than previous Ravan. Why Kali, Prakriti is naked, without any cloth, Prakriti laughing. Come on, O Purush, Jivatma, wounded soul, Purush mean enjoying mood. You want to enjoy me in naked form and laughing. You don't know, I am your, you know, mother. You should not enjoy me. You cannot enjoy me. Only Shiva, Shankar can enjoy me. Shankar. That's why Devi. And those Muslim brothers and other brothers, they are fighting. Those who are, they are worshipping, you know, naked, you know, woman. Actually, they don't know. They are innocent. They don't know. They are passing this kind of remark. Actually, Devi is not naked, but Prakriti, we are actually, when you are going to wear one nice cloth, and suppose one small ant is there inside your cloth, then inside your cloth, completely inside your cloth, that ant can look that you are naked, but actually you are not naked. And dig. In Sanskrit, those who are having some knowledge in Sanskrit, they can understand. Dig jar bhoshan iti digvas. Digvas means, bas means bhoshan, cloth. Dig. All four corners are the cloth of Ma, mother, nature, Prakriti Devi. So cloth is there, but we find she is naked because we are inside Matai. So we can see she is naked. And also another philosophy I already told. We are having so dirty enjoying mood that never nature can excuse us. Never, in infinity, never. If you can get Kripa from Guru Vishnu and start realizing that prakriti is not an objective of my enjoyment. All items there in infinity world, all and each and every item is the object of seva, Krishna seva. If you can realize your body is also one item of Krishna seva. If you can realize someday, then surely you can get tattva gyan. So you see, prakriti, we cannot enjoy prakriti, but we can take prasadam. Prasadam mean, many times I explained before, if I am going to enjoy prasadam, it is no more, it is prasadam. If prasadam going to get overpower over me, my thinking power, my, you know, enjoying all prasad. That's why it is written, prasado seva kurityo hai sakal prapancho joy. That's why Uddhavji Maharaj speaking, Prabhu, sabras alankaro charchitaha, your all your used item, all your chandan, all your garland, all your cloth, all your scent, all your, you know, uchishta, all uchishta prasadam. Sabras alankritaha, we can take as prasadam. Tabo maya jaye mahi. Jaye mahi, we can conquer your maya. We can get, you know, victory over maya. But if you forcefully speak, I can get victory over maya, then maya can kick you. Nobody, even Shankar Bhagavan cannot speak, I can get victory over maya. Maya is so strong. Though Shankar Bhagavan is Mrityunjaya, though Shankar Bhagavan is, you know, Kamjoyi, but still, Bhagavad Maya is so heavy, nobody can get out of the control of this Maya. Only those who are taking shelter unto lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava mean. It means they are going to take shelter unto the lotus feet of Bhagavan. They can go. Sadhu Guru Kipa Bina Na Dekhi Upai. So without realization, if we go to preaching field, then we can make some garbage. Another point I speak, that many times I told the that this material world is the perverted reflection of the transcendental world. This material world is a perverted reflection of that material world, this transcendental world. So this material world can 100% can give evidence there is some transcendental eternal world is there. That material world can 100% prove there is some eternal world is existing somewhere. But it is out of my range, out of my range, out of my reach. I cannot. But be sure, ego regarding tattva explanation many times before, in writing and speaking I told, that if antaranga sakti is eternal, Bhagavad antaranga sakti is eternal. So if Bhagavad antaranga sakti is eternal, then Bhagavad bahiranga sakti is also eternal for infinity pure spirit. Bhagavad antaranga sakti is eternal sakti, but Bhagavad bahiranga sakti has no existence inside Krishna, but still it is eternal. Because if antaranga sakti is eternal, then if the shadow of antaranga sakti is bahiranga sakti, if there is no antaranga sakti, then we can lose the existence of bahiranga sakti. So antaranga sakti is eternal, bahiranga sakti is also eternal. So inside bonded soul, vidya abidya, vidya mean knowledge, actual tattva gyan. Abidya mean ignorance, maya. For infinity period, both there inside. Only it is waiting. When the jivatma can come in front of Guru Vaishnava, if they are lucky, because if you think by your money power, manpower, you can get satsanga, then you are idiot number one. Then you are idiot number one. You don't never try to think that way. By money power, manpower, we cannot get. Satsanga prapate pumhi bahubir sukriti purva sanchitvai. If your luck is very good, then we can get the scope to get a satsanga. Even after getting satsanga, we can find fault with satsanga. Guru Vaishnava, then we can again fall down, again we can throw ourselves into the ocean of Mayadevi. So, Vidya, Vidya, both there for infinity period. Vidya, Vidya. So, how to cut? This is the point. So, for infinity period, Jivatma running this way, by chance, if they get the kripa of, by chance, if they get the kripa of Guru Vaishnava, they can go out of Maya, actual kripa, not false kripa. Sometimes false kripa can come you, Lord, because you like to get some material advantage, love, priya, patishtha, honor, money, position, everything. So Guru Bhat Padma, Guru Vaishnava can cheat you and give you everything. That you get away. Jayathamang prapadanti tang stativa bhajami aham. Popa never wanted to allow us to follow this procedure. Popa told, even those who are going to think me as the enemy, also I am going to pray for them unto lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Those who are going to think me their enemy, because I wanted to speak them all about their absolute truth. Those who are going to think me as enemy unnecessarily, even for them, I am going to pray unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Oh Prabhu, never I want to grow negative conception about them. Even for them, I am going to pray unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Oh Prabhu, like Prahlad Maharaj. Oh Prabhu, you will have to arrange some, you know, absolute benefit for them. They don't know. They are busy with Maya. They are always busy with Maya. They don't know what to do. And Guru Vaishnava, they are not in Maya. They are never in Maya. That's why they can deliver you. They are never in Maya. If they are in Maya, who can save you then? So it is written about Supreme Lord and Guru Vaishnava also, that though they are coming in this material world, though you can find that they are coming in the material world, but still, they are not, you know, they are not within Maya. They are never within Maya. They are always out of Maya. Though they are coming here to deliver us, Srila Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj used to say, until and unless we are going to follow a pure Guru Vaishnava from heart, until and unless we are going to follow a pure Guru Vaishnava from heart, there is no possibility. There is no bohu, you have to suffer much with great difficulty, with great difficulty, with you know great difficulty, and you have to increase your patience. Yeah, you go on doing bohu kasto, you have to suffer so much, you have to suffer, you have to bear, you have to increase your enduring power. Continuously, if your mood is to get sastanga, nothing else. Gaur Kishore Babaji, if you are continuously you are going to pray to Supreme Lord, give me sastanga. To maintain sastanga in your life, you have to suffer. You have to suffer much. So much difficulties can come in your life. So much people can attack you. So much people can insult you. So with great difficulty, if you can increase your enduring power, if you can stay with satsanga mentally and physically, and if you can maintain the honor of Krishnanam, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare Rama, Hare Rama, no! If you can maintain the honor of dignity of Krishnanam, seva, if you can do, and if you are going to throw your soul and heart into the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava, if you are going to get solution in your life through the procedure of pranipat, parivesan, seva, it is called sadhu sangha. You can understand this point, what Gaurakishore Bhaji Maharaj is speaking? This is called actually sadhu sangha. Not that only here, harikatha, after that I can go and you know, take so much enjoyment and, you know, Gaurakishore Bhaji Maharaj is speaking. Continuously through pranipat, parivesan, seva, and with this mood of, you know, tolerance, you know, big tolerance, and you will have to suffer, you have to bear so much. After that, continuously, non-stop, you have your mentality to get satsanga. No satsanga, always satsanga. This way you can go, if you can go on doing Harinam, I mean, if you can maintain the dignity or the honor of Harinam Prabhu Seva, Harinam Prabhu Seva, in that case, it is called actual satsanga. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur can speak that way. We cannot pray. It is not possible for us. Sargeva niraya thaki, hena. Poshupakki hoye thaki sargeva niraye. Poshupakki hoye thaki sargeva niraye. Tava bhakti rohu bhakti vinodu hidaye. So you see, Bhaktivinoda Thakur praying this way. Oh Prabhu, poshupakki hoye thaki sargeva. I mean, Bhaktivinoda Thakur never wanted to get asasanga. Continue. Maybe I am beast, but still, I want to get the association satsanga. Tava bhakti rahu bhakti mean? Vittasur also praying unto Lord Sweet of Sangsar Chakra Bhamataha. In course of traveling this, you know, material world, in different body. Tavo janishu saksham. I like to grow friendship with your devotee, pure devotees. This is our prayer. So this way. Now, actually Maya is not there. But still, we think Maya is, it is impossible for us to cut Maya. I already told according to scriptural evidence, actually Jivatma, pure Jivatma have no connection, nothing to do with Maya. Useless. Pure Jivatma have no connection with Maya. But still, we cannot cut Maya. What is the problem? How? That we should calculate, understand. First of all, I told according to our previous sanskar, bad sanskar, we are growing our habit to enjoy Maya, Prakriti. We want to enjoy Prakriti Devi. My body, you know, Kriti Apatej Marudbom, it is also made up of the ingredients from Maya. Your body is also, everything, all everything from Maya. And one objective we can see, and according to their previous sanskar, they are developing enjoying mood. Somebody feeling some attraction from that thing, somebody feeling some attraction from this thing. This way everybody busy with enjoyment. But it is one kind of, you know, magic spell of Maya. I can give one example. Actually, Guru Bhargava speaking, suppose Pushparath, you know, the chariot used by Ramchandra when coming back from Sri Lanka. Pushparath having some expanding, you know, property. Sometime expansion and contraction, like Dhamma. It is Dhamma, like Dhamma. So, and they are full troops. Hanumanji Maharaj, Ram, Lakshan, Sita, everybody, they are climbing on the chariot, they are, you know, flying, and that plane, chariot coming. Guru Bhargava speaking, if that Pushparath is up, if we can get the shadow inside, you know, water, same Pushparath, same thing, same decoration, everything. I can see, you know, in a mirror, or in water lake, if a foolish like to jump into the lake to ride that Pushparath, is it possible? Do you think it is, you know, is possible? Not possible. Same example we can get from Guru Bhargava. Those who are going to show that they are Raganuga devotees, Guru Bhargava speaking, Prabhupada speaking, that actually there is a, if there is a nice, you know, nice quality honey, there is nice quality honey there, honey. That honey is Padda Madhu, lotus honey. And lotus honey is so nice flavor, going to attack honeybees. But you are so clever, you are going to put that honey inside a pot, glass pot, very transparent pot, and you seal the neck, I mean covering. After that, all, you know, all butterfly, all, you know, those, you know, honeybees, they are coming around that bottle full of that Padda Madhu. They like to enjoy that Padda Madhu, but they cannot get in touch with Padda Madhu. Only they can sit on the body of that glass jar, and they are licking. Actually, they have no direct contact with that Madhu. Guru Bhargava giving this example that they are foolish. They like, they think that they are doing Raganuga Bhajan, Rupanuga Bhajan, but they are actually outside that glass jar, and inside that jar is secretly kept protection, in full protection. Guru Bhargava, Rupa Goswami, Sanatana, all they are keeping it secretly so that unwanted element cannot come and make disturbance. So you see, they are licking, sitting on the glass jar body, and licking, but they are never going to get. And so, I can give example one by one, so that you can understand that it is not possible. But Prabhupada wanted to speak this way: the day you can concentrate your mind under lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava to feel their viraha, separation, you know, seva mood. If we can go on, you know, getting this kind of Guru Vaishnava gone, this kind of, you know, viraha kathar, Prabhupada, in the, because Prabhupada wanted to speak, never try to enjoy with that Vishaya Vigraha. Don't try to jump into the rasatattva of that Vishaya Vigraha. Before that, Prabhupada suggesting all the time you have to discuss about the rasatattva of Guru Vaishnava. They have also different kinds. They are feeling pain, they are joking sometimes, they are all transcendental. Their mood, all is if you parivate asray vigre rasalochana. What your Gurudev is that? What is his mood? How he used to recite this? How he used to cry? You know, Birahaya, this kind of Prabhupada used to speak. If you are going to think about that Asray Vigraha Rasatattva, then someday you can step into the Vishaya Vigraha Rasatattva. It's called Sahajya. So, one by one I can go on explaining what is the Siddhanta of Prabhupada and what is my Siddhanta. How I am totally deviated from the track of Srila Prabhupada, that I can discuss one by one. Actually, one day, a queen in a kingdom, one queen taking bath in a very solitary place in a lake, and she going to keep all his ornament, you know, necklace, very costly, in a tree, and after that, changing clothes, she is going to take bath. After that, she can again wear ornaments, everything, because she is queen. In the meantime, one bird coming, like vulture, and taking that costly, you know, that, you know, necklace, and gone. And that queen started shouting. After that, king came to know that one bird taken away that, you know, necklace. Very nice, very costly. Then the king announcing that those who can deliver this, you know, necklace, anyway secretly see, anybody going to, you know, get the information about the necklace, then we can give donation to them, big donation. Then everybody is running here and there to take the information. And, you know, that the vulture sitting in a big lake, when a big up in a tree, top, and the picture of that necklace is there. Necklace is there. Because that bird gone, somehow, a necklace in, you know, necklace is there, you know, oscillating in air. And some police villager, they are going to discover, oh, this necklace is there, you see, inside water. Some jumping into water to get it, but they cannot get. They cannot get everybody. And same argument getting there. And in Bhagavatam also, very nice. Everybody jumping, trying to catch that necklace, but nobody can do it. Ultimately, when sadhu was going that way, the sadhu stopped, what going on, what kind of, you know, is curiosity. That sadhu watching, oh, everybody fighting with that, oh, there's a condition. Then after that, the sadhu laughing and speaking, oh, idiot, foolish, you see, the necklace is there inside water, not there, it is up, look at the top, there is a necklace. You are all wasting your time there. This way, we are all like that foolish villager. We are going to waste our time to get enjoyment. But, oh man, enjoyment is not there in this material world. Enjoyment is there in the transcendental world. It is the perverted reflection of that transcendental world. We are so foolish, we are going to waste our time to get that kind of enjoyment. Simply, we are going to waste our time. First of all, before starting our actual bhajan, we must go out of this mood, enjoying mood. We must go. We should not try to enjoy Maya. It's a Maya. Those pure Guru Vaishnava, they are leading their sansar. It is not Maya. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Sivas Pandit, you know, Sivananda Sen, Mahaprabhu very happy. Mahaprabhu very happy, Mahaprabhu forecasting to Sivananda, Sivananda, next time when you are going to get another baby, that boy, you can keep his name this, Mahaprabhu laughing. If Mahaprabhu at all angry with family life, so why? Eh? No, not that. Mahaprabhu wanted to teach us that this is the procedure. This is not the procedure what you are following. This is not the procedure. The procedure is that you have to do this. Now I go back to the sloka I started with. Vaktistai sthiratara bhagavan jadi sat daivena na falate dibbo kishora murtihi muktihi swayam mukulitanjali sevate asmano dharmartha kamagatayo samayo pratiksha. First of all, I like to quote what Popa speaking. Even anartha is there inside you. If we have that kind of technique to utilize that anartha for Krishna Seva, it's top secret in our technology. If we have that kind of mood, if we have that kind of technology, how to utilize? Because Bali Maharaj wanted to utilize, you know, all different kind of example we can give. They wanted to utilize there in Billa Mangal, different kind of anartha was there. But Billa Mangal wanted to utilize this anartha in Krishna Seva in different way. Anartha was there with that pros, you know, Avanti Nagar. I was discussing long ago that pros Vesha, you know, in Bhagavatam it is written, Krishna speaking to Uddhava. Anartha was there, but she wanted to utilize it. Anartha is there with Lakshahira by the association Guru Vaishnava, they want to change it. We can go on fighting with Anartha. We can go on fighting with Maya for infinity period. But no result you can arrive. You can never come out successful. You will have to follow the exact procedure. So now I like to explain this sloka, you can understand. That bhakti stai sthiratara bhagavan jodi shat. Shat mean if suddha bhakti is there, going to take place in my heart, and if I can see the picture of Radha Govinda only and only, if I can see Radha Govinda sitting inside my heart, bhakti stai sthiratara bhagavan jodi shat, daivena na phalata dibya kishora murti, in that case mukti hi swayam mukilitanjali sevato asmano dharmartha kam gatayo samayo pratiksha. You are running like foolish and idiot. Vyan lab puja patishta. I can give countless examples. Those who are pure Guru Vaishnav, they are not going to spend money for their own patishta, automatic. It's an automatic. Patishta going to follow them. Patishta going to follow them. They are not going to follow, they are lying to hide themselves. But, you know, patishtar bhaye puri jay pari palaiya, patishta par, in the fear, for the fear of patishta, Madhavendra Puri Pas Hindi, I can get contaminated, patishta going to touch me, so I can go away. I can go away from here. But Madhavendra Puri Pas cannot escape, because that patishta given by Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Nityananda. Patishta sabhav ei jaina chahe tar hai vidata nirmito. It is arranged by Nityananda himself, Balaram, Guru, Adi Guru. So how Madhavendra Puri Pas like to fly, go away, but Madhavendra cannot. Patishta going to follow him, give him honor. But the more you are going to give Patishta to Guru Vaishnav, Guru Vaishnav can cry and cry in love of Guru Varga. They can cry, Prabhu, you are going to give me Patishta. Oh, yes, one contamination, I don't like to take it. I have seen practically, when 100 years, you know, celebration, completion of Guru Padpadmana Abhibhav Tithi was there in Puri, that time I was very sick, you know, malaria. But still I was doing publication job with full enthusiastic attitude, but daily heavy fever, but doing forcefully. Then in Puri I reach ultimately with books and everything, magazine, that I have no power to do anything there. So weak. And I have seen that everybody going to glorify Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, the topmost Paramahansa, and Guru Padpadma shrugging his head, is looking down and shedding tears. Ah, they are going to give honor to me. What honor I can expect from them? And when devotee is requesting him to speak something, Guru Maharaj, out of prema, cannot speak anything. Trying to speak, but cannot speak. He's crying, shedding tears. And all this patishta we should give to Prabhupada. Why you are giving to me? So this is called Vaishnavi Patishta. For Patishta, if you at all think about Patishta, 100% beat for sure. Vaishnavi Patishta, only Guru Vaishnava can deserve Patishta. Only and only Patishta, Vaishnavi Patishta waiting for pure Guru Vaishnava, not for ordinary man. So we need not run behind love, puja, patishta, here and there, to collect money, position and all. You need not go. Preaching can automatically be done by you, if Nityananda is going to help you. Nobody can stop your preaching. Be sure. Only you will have to leave your duplicity. So, Billamangal Thakur speaking, bhakti stai sthiratara. Sthiratara means stability of bhakti. When stability of Krishna Bhakti is there, inside your heart, giving you full transcendental bliss, and Radha Govinda appear inside your heart all the time, mentally you like to say, do savor that, divine consort, Radha Govinda. In that case, you need not go here. You need not go anywhere automatically. Even mukti, for mukti liberation, also foolish in yogi, gyani, they are trying. But Billamangal Thakur going to explain that why you are going to flatter, you know, unto a lot of mukti swayam, mukti, you know, can come and pray unto a lotus feet of unto your lotus feet. Please accept me with folded hand. Mukti going to stand. Mukti going to stand. Mukti actually is strilinga, feminine jitta. Mukti going to stand with folded hand. She like to pray unto your lotus feet. Pure devotee, please accept me. Pure devotee says, no. We don't need mukti. We have nice explanation of mukti. Muktir hitva annatharupam, muktir hitva annatharupam, sarupena vyavasthiti iti mukti. This is the exact definition of Gauri devotees. So now, what to speak about dharmartha kama gataya samaya pakata, dharmo, artho, kama, moksho, all going to stand in front of a pure devotee with folded hand to request, please accept something from me. This is the situation of pure devotee, you know. Bhakti stai stiratara, bhakti stai stiratara, bhagavan jadi shad, daivena na, falati dibba kishara murtihi, muktihi swayam mukulitanjali sevata asman, dharmartha kamagatayo samaya pratiksha, kasmad bhajanti kavayo dhanadurma dandhan. Baba speaking, we'll have to carry on our mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. It is the direct order of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Go and broadcast my teachings to everybody, but be careful. Don't try to allow any duplicity inside your heart. Always try to get established in acharan, etiquette, acharan, siddhanta, shown by me. Be careful. Otherwise, you can get a great feedback, punishment by Mayadevi. More and more, you can go down into the ocean of Maya. Be careful. It is a standing instruction of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Go and broadcast my teachings and try to accept my etiquette, Vaishnava Acharan, everything. Don't try to run from Lab Puya Padishtha. You can die, you can kill all your followers. Be careful. Try to speak about that absolute truth, absolute way, standing on absolute platform, as shown by Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada. Paramhansa varam paramatha patim patito dharane krita vesha jatim jati rajaganai pariseva padam panamami sada prabhupada padam Pranamami sada Prabhupada padam, Pranamami sada Prabhupada padam, Vanchakalpadurvasya kepa sindhavacha, Patitanam pavana bhavishna pyo namo.